So the Prime Minister updated me on his assessments on the situation in the region and developments in the different countries in the regions which are not members of the alliance. And I appreciate that very much because it was an informative update on the situation in the countries in the region. We of course follow the developments in the Western Balkans very closely because NATO has a history in the Balkans, in the Western Balkans. We have helped to end two wars there, Bosnia-Herzegovina and later on in Serbia and Kosovo. And we have presence there with our KFOR force in Kosovo, but also with our headquarters in Sarajevo and presence also in Skopje. And Serbia is a close partner. I also worked on the fact that we have been able to then enlarge the alliance with Montenegro. We did so last year. And we are working with other ASEAN countries in the region. We have seen reports about increased Russian presence and also attempts to meddle or interfere in domestic political processes. Of course, any kind of outside interference is unacceptable, and therefore it is important that all countries in the region, as other neighbor allies, have to make sure that they are resilient and are able to respond to different attempts to try to meddle in domestic processes.
We, of course, discussed extensively and exchanged views about the situation in our neighborhood, especially in the four countries which are not yet members of NATO, two of them clearly defined ambition, and one of them not having this ambition at this stage, and one of them not being able to fulfill this ambition. I explained to the Secretary General the level of the dynamics and the intensity of the relationship that we have with all our neighbors, where we will be very much welcoming that Macedonia follow the steps of Montenegro. I think that would stabilize in the long run the country's position and put on track the entire reform processes, and also the fact that Croatia is keen to resolve all the remaining issues that are somehow residual from the times of the beginning of the 90s with the other neighbors and contribute to the stability and the equality of all three peoples in Bosnia and Herzegovina, especially the Croats, who are at least two knows their numbers, but should be and are equal in terms of their constitutional rights, especially given the forthcoming elections in October. When it comes to the fighter jets, of course, the Secretary General is aware that my government has been the first government in many years after long debates who did not hesitate a second on the necessity to acquire the capabilities when it comes to the air capabilities of the Croatian military forces. The process, which we call G2G, is coming to a close. We have examined all the offers that have finally been addressed to the Ministry of Defense, who have been conducting this process. And in the next few weeks, the final decisions will be published. So we are close to the end of that process. It's a long-term strategic decision that will position Croatia as even more reliable NATO partner, but also it will increase our own security and solve the issues of Croatian Air Force for the next 30 years. So it is not a decision that should not be taken with due care and all aspects being considered.